Man, the humble, cute little Squee-G. We've had it in the game since Splatoon 1 as a type of enemy that climbs both the walls and the floors in single player, hungry for ink to take in. While Nintendo has been happy to share with us a bunch of the special weapons coming to Splatoon 3, they've been real quiet-like on the subweapons that we should expect. And it makes you wonder, are we gonna see a lot of new subweapons in Splatoon 3? And if so, what would he make them, you know? We want to make sure that the Squee-G sub still acts like its single-player brethren, though. I think there are a couple of ground rules we need to establish early on. First of all, the Squee-G should be able to climb walls. I think that any vertical surface, inkable or not, should be climbable by a Squee-G. If there's a bump in the wall, or if the wall, like, turns upside down, the Squee-G won't be able to climb it, just like a player. That means a Squee-G can climb on top of the center of Inkblot Art Academy, but not the statues on the side of the map. Now, we know that the curling bomb is already in Splatoon 3, based on the trailer, assuming it wasn't just a stand-in for the development team, so we do already have one throwable, ground-crawling sub-weapon. If the Squee-G is too powerful, it could outclass the curling bomb. Just like the curling bomb, I would say that it's fine for the Squee-G to do a little bit of damage when it touches an opponent. After all, in the single-player mode when you fight the larger Squee-Gs, anytime they touch you, they do a bunch of damage. Of course, those guys do way too much damage, so I think it'd be better if this guy only did enough that he could four-shot. I think in the ballpark of 26-27 damage shouldn't be that bad. The Squee-G should be more about tracking and chip damage than about mobility and effectiveness at killing. While the curling bomb paints a path for the player as it moves forward, the Squee-G wouldn't do this, which means that we can't take advantage of it to move around. But in a dangerous situation, it could remove enemy ink at the player's feet, say you go too deep into enemy turf, and that would normally prevent a player from, you know, being able to do much. But instead, you'd just be able to walk away, because there wouldn't be enemy ink on the ground thanks to your Squee-G. You also wouldn't be able to refill your ink tank right away when you chuck a Squee-G, so you would have to be careful about that. We want to also make sure that the Squee-G has some kind of opponent sensing technique, similar to the story mode where it prioritizes opponents over you, but obviously as a sub-weapon it wouldn't be able to harm or chase your teammates. It'd be good if the Squee-G could sense opponents that are in front of it, as well as below it. This would give a slight advantage to having a Squee-G, because let's say there's a random opponent sharking right below you. You could chuck a Squee-G out first so it goes near the edge. It might sense the opponent that's below it, and then be able to kind of, in a way, call it out so you don't end up falling down there and getting hit by that opponent. It could be the only sub in the game that's able to find opponents and actually move around like a point sensor or an autobomb. At the same time, we don't want to make the autobomb irrelevant, so I don't think the Squee-G's gonna blow up when it's done. I guess it can just deactivate and fade away, kind of like a point sensor does? I'm not sure how you'd finish off the Squee-G, but it doesn't make sense for the Squee-G to blow up. I don't think that would make other bombs kind of at the same level as it, at least like within the autobomb category. Just imagine the Squee-G in a number of the ranked modes. It'd be more useful in something like Splat Zones, where you could forcibly take away the zone just for your guy. Imagine you're painting the zone, and your Squee-G is at the same time just taking away enemy ink when they put it down. Nice. It wouldn't be great for tower control, though, because you chuck it at the tower, it tries to climb up if you aim it correctly, and then it's just gonna hit the grate and fall back down, so... You know, it'll have some good places, some bad places. If you throw it onto the top of the tower, though, like let's say you're standing on it, I guess it would take away enemy ink if you're having a fight on there. Pretty useful. Imagine just cutting somebody off in Rainmaker. They're moving forward the Rainmaker and the path they put down. You just, you chuck the Squee-G in a way, and now they're just running towards the Rainmaker path. No more path, and they got the Squee-G coming after them. That's just... funny. I think the Squee-G is unique enough that it'd be super fun to use as a less lethal but very useful sub-weapon in Splatoon 3. I think people would just love to have them to troll people, and they're cute, and it'd be funny. Do you think you could make the Squee-G work? Oh my god, what if there was a Squee-G crab weapon? That'd be amazing. And I'd want to have that on my kit for, like, the first week of the game being out. I hope you liked this little ramble. If you enjoyed the idea or my expansion on it, please consider liking or subscribing so you can see more in the future. See you later.